So, you're going fossil hunting and you don't know what to take. I'm a geologist, I fossil hunt regularly in Dorset, and I thought I'd show you what I take in my bag. First things first, I've got a nice rugged backpack that doesn't matter if it gets a little bit muddy, because there's often a lot of clay about. Actually, this is meant for surfing, so it's got a little wetsuit bit in the back, so it keeps it a bit waterproof. You want something that distributes the weight nice and evenly so that you don't end up with a bad back because you've been lugging rocks around all day. And obviously, you want your bag to be pretty empty so you can fill it up, if you're in a spot that you're allowed to. Secondly, I have a hammer and a chisel to be able to get into any of those stubborn rocks. I would say the hammer and the chisel aren't always essential. A lot of what you can find will just be loose on the beach. So this is a fine tipped chisel and this is a flat tipped chisel. And between the two of them, it can help break down any big finds that I might have so that it doesn't weigh as much in my bag. If I want to cut something on a specific plane, that's how I do it. It doesn't need to be anything fancy. I think this one was a fiver from Wilco. It really is simple stuff here. Now we've opened the rocks, we need to think about how we're gonna try and take home what we found. I bring all sorts of little bags and boxes that I might be able to store anything delicate in, because I don't want them getting lost and beaten up on the bottom of my bag. Anything will really do for this, any sort of sandwich bags, Tupperware, whatever's lying about. But you want to make sure you can protect your finds. Next up, I always carry a hi-vis, not for myself, but actually for my bag. I have a real habit of wandering off and leaving my bag on the beach, because these beaches are often quite remote and quiet. So by attaching this and leaving it face up, it means that I don't lose my bag. Another handy thing that I recommend is a little piece of paper in the back that you can print off in advance, showing you a little bit of what you might be looking for in the area, especially if this is a new place that you're not familiar with. Just print off a few common finds so that you can match up to things that you see on the beach. This one in particular, I've given friends before for Charmouth Beach in Dorset. It can really help to just help train your eye in when you first get there. I've even been known to take geological maps with me so that I can track which rock beds that I might be finding the particular fossils out of at that time. On to the more health and safety things. Always bring water. No matter how quick you think the fossil hunt is, you're gonna get distracted, you're gonna get sidetracked. Always safe to have water on hand. And on that note, top up sun cream, always essential, or if it's in the other end of the year, waterproofs, something warm and dry to put on afterwards. I also often bring a portable charger. The last thing you need is to have some sort of health and safety issue and you can't phone someone because your phone's out of charge. Now, footwear. On some beaches, trainers are going to be just fine. You want something that's nice and rugged that you're not going to get loose fitting, but many beaches, especially along the Jurassic Coast, you're going to want wellies or you're going to want something with ankle support. Whatever you do, flip-flops are not fossil hunting gear. Obviously, this list isn't exhaustive, but this will get most people going. See you out there.